Jerry, no. You're trying to tell me that Bowers and Wilkins developed a smart speaker that can play down to a realistic 35 hertz in the room? Come on, I'll review that when I see speakers fly, because that is ridiculous. Let me call you back. Oh my God. Well, they did it. Bowers and Wilkins actually did it. They brought back the Zeppelin. Now, you may remember the Zeppelin, or at least a history class lesson on it. The famous lighter-than-air craft from the late 20s and early 30s that was like a blimp, but kind of the prototype and way cooler. But of course, I had no doubt that Bowers could pull something marvelous like this off. After all, they're an engineering company and they do virtually everything in-house. Kind of like Rolls-Royce, jet engines, world's nicest cars, all of it. And the Zeppelin here is the best proof of concept because while it may be named after a lighter-than-air craft and it may not fly, it sure makes your music fly to you, and does so with bass notes that you won't believe are coming out of a smart speaker. So I've got a lot to say about the return of one of the best products in its category, but before then, subscribe to the Gramophone channel and just click that little bell notification icon down there because tons of cool stuff is coming up for you guys. Now let's open up this hangar and launch this airship. All right, so when we get into the top, first thing I find, good old trusty power cable, because, you know, power. We got some literature here, I think, that I ripped. Don't do that. Quick start guide, safety and warning. And that does it. Let's get this thing out. I wish this really was lighter than air. All right, so this is the new Zeppelin. Nicely shaped, much like a Zeppelin, maybe a little bit like half a football as well. Looking at the front here, you got a more classic fabric grille design. Oh yeah, look at that. That is a really nice built-in foot. That also, so you can access the screws underneath. Okay, cool. And now that's not going anywhere. Perfect. So the new Zeppelin here is carrying the legacy of a formerly great smart speaker and taking it into a new era, bringing back the iconic design, and giving us the connectivity we're going to be looking for today. So what exactly can it do? What can we connect to? A surprising host of things I am happy to report. All of the usual suspects. We've got Apple AirPlay 2, Qualcomm's aptX HD codec for Bluetooth, specifically Bluetooth version 5.0 with this product, which is really all we need in terms of achieving the best in Bluetooth streaming quality that's currently available. It also works using the natively designed Bowers & Wilkins app. Through that app, we can integrate services such as Tidal, Deezer, Last.fm, Qobuz, SoundCloud, NTS, and Dash. And then, of course, by utilizing Apple AirPlay, if you have any other source of audio from your phone, that can be effectively cast to the Zeppelin. All of this provides us with one of the best ranges of streaming that we could really hope for. Being able to use AirPlay gets you, well, quite literally whatever you want from your phone over Apple. Bluetooth does make this usable for Android users, but not at the level of quality that we should expect right now. I would, for our Android-using friends, like to see Chromecast added. But also having the app with the native integration for all of those very popular music services is definitely a very positive step in the right direction. And coming from where Bowers has been in the world of smart products and streaming, this is definitely a huge improvement and a move in a very positive direction. And I can't emphasize that enough. So the Zeppelin has got almost a true three-way system going on here, and it does this all with 240 watts of total amplifier power. 240 watts crammed into half a football, elongated and turned into a replica of an old flying machine is really good. And no, and I mean that in a great way. The Zeppelin's a really cool looking speaker. As far as drivers go, we have a 150 millimeter or 6-inch subwoofer built into the Zeppelin. On top of that, for our mid-range drivers, we have two 3.5-inch FST mid-ranges. 3.5-inch mid-range, while that might seem a little smaller than what you're used to hearing me talk about on a pair of bookshelves or tower speakers, well, Of course it is. The fact that we were able to get a 6-inch low frequency driver is already impressive enough. And for a speaker of this size, 3.5 is actually going to serve the mids quite well. So not only do we get two mid-range drivers, we get two dome tweeters as well, a proper 1-inch dome, like an actual bookshelf or tower speaker. So what about the aesthetics of the Zeppelin? It's a product that kind of speaks for itself. It has a very modern-esque flavor to it with not only the shape, of course, but you have a classic, but also kind of solid, somewhat rigid fabric front. It's not kind of like the speaker grills of old. It's got a modern flair to it. Looking down at the foot underneath, it sits very stably on this aluminum foot. And I really like the added touch of just that little bit of white LED illumination. Looking at the top, we've got a few tactile buttons here. It's always nice when you see these on a smart product, because while you will be on your phone 90% of the time, if you just want to press a pause or a play button, it just feels good. You know what I mean? Good feeling buttons. This is multifunction. That's going to vary depending on the context of how you're setting up your product. This is going to be used for voice assistant. And of course, plus and minus, I'm sure you know what that does. There's your volume. And as far as hardwire connectivity, there really isn't any of that beyond a simple USB-C service port. And really all that is, I believe, is for software and just your typical two-prong power cable. I get that this is going for hands-free. And in this world of high-res Wi-Fi streaming, where even Apple Music is lossless and high-quality stuff now, I do kind of get it. So that can be forgiven. The Zeppelin goes really low. Like surprisingly low in the bass department, and that I think is its best feature. That genuinely surprised me. I did not really think, even with those 6-inch bass drivers, that we were going to get that out of this body, but we did. Mid-range performance is fair. I think in that transition from mids to highs, it's a little lean, but the higher highs do come back, and for a product of this form factor, it does have power in bass for days. I played this at 75% volume and that almost hurt my ears. Gosh forbid I would have gone up to 100. So if you need loud, the Zeppelin can definitely do loud. Trying out Apple Music's new lossless streaming over AirPlay 2 to the Zeppelin, I put on one of my favorites by John Mark McMillan. He's an alternative artist that has just an awesome kind of bassy, gravelly, baritone male voice. It makes some pretty unique music. That sounded pretty good on the Zeppelin, being that he is more toward the bottom end of mid-range and that naturally deeper voice. That I think is also where this Zeppelin shined. I might be a little more critical of how it performs with female vocals, but if you're into loud, bassy, something that has an iconic design and comes from one of the best manufacturers in audio, so you know that the quality is there, then the Zeppelin is certainly for you. So if you're interested in picking up a Zeppelin for yourself, and that sounds like you, you can pick one up for just under $800 over at skybygramophone.com. Our links are in the description down below. And while you're on Sky, we can ship it fast and free straight to your door after a secure checkout. Also, this is something you can purchase in store. You'll find us in Timonium, Columbia in Gaithersburg. Finally, we have a beautiful kitchen design center that can help you with all of your interior design needs over in Hunt Valley. I'd really appreciate a thumbs up. Drop a comment down below. What do you think of the Zeppelin, if you've heard it? And of course, please tell me what you'd like to see from us in the future. I want to get some stuff you guys really want. So thanks for watching. And of course, be seeing you.